This episode of Cook Club with Janet Keeler is brought to you by Williams-Sonoma.
Hi, I'm Janet Keeler, the food editor of the Tampa Bay Times. Welcome to this episode of Cook Club. With Thanksgiving on the way, I'm thinking about dishes that can do double duty as a side dish and as a main dish for vegetarians. So I'm thinking that butternut squash pasta casserole with Gruyere and pecans will fit the bill. The most challenging task about this recipe is peeling the butternut squash. Its skin is thin, so it's not too difficult to do with a sturdy peeler. Use a flat surface to steady the odd-shaped veggie. After the squash is peeled, cut it in two pieces so that it's easier to handle. The seeds are in the bulbous part of the squash. After it's cut in half, get a spoon to scrape out the seeds. You'll find the inside similar to a stringy pumpkin. Calls for fresh sage leaves, coarsely chopped. I stack them on top of each other and cut them that way, and then give them another rough chop. Leftover leaves can be used for garnish. I like to toast nuts in dry pan on the stove. As soon as you detect a fragrant aroma, they are done. Take them off the heat and out of the pan, or they will continue to cook and burn. The toasted nuts are spread on top of the casserole just before it goes into the oven. I add more cheese on top of them so that melts while it's baking. I hope these tips help you to make butternut squash pasta casserole with Gruyere and pecans. For Tampa Bay Times and Cook Club, I'm Janet Keeler.